Go. 3, 2, 1, go. All right. What's up, guys? Hey, I am Mario. Peaches, and this is Super Mario 64 with one hand.
Hello.
I'm not really a Super Mario 64 runner. I like to do it for fun. And back in like 2011, I was riding my bike and a van ran a stop sign and hit me and I broke my wrist. And the only way that I could play was with one hand. And I had a lot of fun doing it, so I just kind of kept with it. And even though I'm not that great of a Super Mario 64 runner, I'm pretty decent with one hand, I'd like to think. So Siglemic didn't want to do a run for Mario 64, so I stepped up and figured I might as well, since people seem to hate when anyone worse than Siglemic plays. And I don't have like a reputation as a Super Mario 64 runner, so if you guys hate this, then I'll take the hit. Okay, at the beginning, you can skip the cutscene with the Lakitu here. I didn't get it, it's pretty precise. But it's not too long. You need to go right along the edge of the bridge to get that. Changing to Mario Cam makes it pretty easy to line up the long jumps to this door. And we're gonna start off with something that's pretty tough with one hand, so fingers crossed that I get it. Okay, I'm gonna change my hand position here. Pretty happy I got that. That failed a lot in practice. Okay. Now we're gonna head right over to Womp's Fortress. And go for another hard trick. All right, let's try again. Alright. So the backup, if you miss Cannonless, is to just go for the side flip star, which sometimes is harder. but. Alright. Okay, I'd like you guys to see Cannonless, though, so I'll try again. I don't want to waste too much time on it. But thankfully, 30 minutes is a moderately generous estimate. Oh, I'm not going for cage. That's a bit too hard. I practiced that for a while. The owl's just too tempting. Oops. I don't have quite a good position here. If you kill him in the right spot, the star appears over you. Oh, apparently I do have a good position. All right. I'll take it. That was definitely on purpose. Yahoo! pretty tough. You can triple jump up to this platform if you time it right, but the side flip's not too bad. If you start a ground pound beneath a star, it'll cancel your jump animation and you can land quicker, which lets you get the star quicker. I forgot to hit A first, so I just did a slide. If you do a side flip dive into here, the owl comes out. It's a little bit faster than climbing up the tree. And this is kind of an awkward thing to do because you have to hold A. So this is supposed to be like a total slam dunk star, but I've failed it before with one hand. Okay. And that's all I'm going to get from Womp's Fortress. I have 6 stars now, which is nice because there's 3 pretty easy stars in Cool Cool Mountain, but I only need to get 2 of them. And the slide is pretty hard to do, so I'm going to skip the slide. Okay, to begin you can just jump straight off the edge. As soon as my shadow disappears, I'm going to hold up. And that lets me get down here. Oop, didn't mean to take damage, but that's fine. Oh. Those wall kicks are pretty hard because you have to change the direction of the stick each time, and that's really awkward to do with just one hand while you're also hitting A. And now I'm just going to get the penguin, which can be hard because he's really slippery. Oh, oh, there we go. All right. And I'm going to do a penguin boost. If you pick up the baby penguin, the mom gets mad and pushes you towards the star. It's not much faster, I just like doing it. Save the animals. No, the Bowser stages are pretty tough, and you have to be really fast at the red coins to make it worth it. And I can't even do this fast with 2 hands, so we're just gonna, yeah. Well, I was trying to pick as many like really hard stars as I could to practice, but I didn't have as much time to practice as I wanted. Thankfully, I got 2 really, really hard tricks right away, so I'm already pretty happy with how it's going. Oops. Okay. It really sucks to die here, so I'm gonna try not to do anything stupid. Oops. Okay. Oh. Thanks so much for not doing anything stupid. Okay, Bowser throws are pretty interesting. Bowser's not super easy to throw to begin with, but on hand it adds an extra dimension. I can throw, spin him, but then you can just hold up on the stick to keep the speed. And because I'm a wuss, I'm gonna just throw him close and then do a little handoff. Go for it, this is a good time.
All right, we have a very special donation of $2,000. And this donation is from the Yeti. Hey all, Yeti Glenn here. We've made it to $21,000 raised from shirts.
Wow.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to give a special shout out to everyone who admins SDA Marathon IRC, to Mike Uyama for kicking more butt each year with this event, and to all the volunteers and staff who work behind the scenes to make this happen. Please put the $2,000 towards Chrono being named Yeti, and good luck to Cosmo on his Wind Waker HD run. And the Yeti's donation has officially pushed us over the $700,000 raised mark.
It's a little bit faster to do dives here to get these coins, but I've fallen into the lava so many times. I'm just gonna chill and take it easy. Pillarless was one of the stars that I really wanted to try and learn, but I just didn't have time. So sadly, I won't be doing that. Okay, please be there, Shy Guy. Okay. Okay. Sometimes the Shy Guy can be in the wrong spot, and it makes that strat very, very hard to do. So that went pretty well.
Curiosity, do you do the bully star if you miss Canonless?
I would do the slide in CCM if I miss Canonless.
Oh, okay.
Okay, this one's pretty awkward. I'll be happy if I get this in one try. Oh no. Okay, abort.
The trollers.
Get out of here.
Yeah.
And now that I have 12 stars, I can talk to that code in the corner. Shots fired. It had to happen at some point.
Bad street.
Yeah, I'll try to do the triple jump wall cake one more time. Oh no, I won't. Get up there. Okay. All right, abort again. Yeah. If I push up against this texture, pop through.
Nice. All right.
All right. Let's go for it one more time.
During this Mario 64 run, if you donate at least $5, you'll be eligible for a Super Mario 64 Japanese cart as one of our many prizes.
Save those 2.7.
Now that we have 15 stars, I'm gonna go for Mips. He's the rabbit.
Yeah!
And not only was it good that I got him quickly, but I got him right next to the door, which is what I need him for. You don't need his star at all, you just need his corpse.
Oh my gosh, what a
okay. That was. That's actually pretty hard to do. That was a really fast clip.
Yeah, that's right.
OK. Okay, I don't want to jinx myself here. Okay. Yeah, that was really good. There's many different ways that could have gone that are worse. The worst would be you can lose MIPS inside of that door, and then I would have to go into a level and die to respawn MIPS. And that's a big time waste. And what I'm doing is here is this is the 16th star. This is kind of the namesake of the category. The reason I need to get a star is to get the water to recede, and that lets me enter Bowser in the Fire Seed. And then I can go upstairs and we'll do some DLJs. Okay, this is deceptively hard. Okay. That, yeah, that would be awful. Oops, didn't quite get up on there. Oof. I don't mind if I take this damage. Yeah, that's fine. That one was on purpose. Cool. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna get this cycle. Okay. Get away from me. No, no, okay. I was trying to escape it, but all right. I'm gonna do safe strats here. Okay. All right. Stinks to miss this throw, so I'm gonna go for it. Okay. If you throw him off the ledge, he jumps back up and tips the stage again. That wastes a bunch of time. Alright. Now here come the BLJs. This is a very hard thing to do. One hand. A lot of people have trouble doing it with two hands, so fingers crossed again that this goes well. I'm gonna exit course to get back to the lobby quickly. And there's a double jump that you can do. I don't want that. I won't be flying. Okay, so I'm gonna turn my camera, zoom out, and let's give this a whirl. Oh, no, no. Too early. Too early to clap. There we go. Okay, now I got it. I'm not gonna go for that triple jump. That saves like 1 second and it kills me a lot. Yeah. Oh. Okay. Whoa. Get up there. Okay. As I said before, Bowser throws are pretty tough, so let's see what I can do. Oh, you might hear in this one. Okay. I'm getting him closer. Wide left, all right. Get ready on time. Time. Okay. Jeez, I should have slowed down a bit so we could hit 100. That went really, really well. My PB for that, by the way, is 21:31. So that was really close to a PB. That went really well. And my PB with two hands is 20:05. So I haven't even cut 20 with two hands. What's that? I can't hear you. Oh yeah, yeah. I've had many two-hand runs that were slower than that, so. All right, I understand that we're still behind, so that's it for me. Thanks for watching, guys.
And Peaches, just FYI, 99,000 people watched that. All right, we got a bunch more donations to read. We have a $1,026.92 donation from Miss Neurofish Fox. AGDQ has been great this year. Thanks to everyone for all the hard work put into the event, and thanks again to everyone who donated and spread the word.